Welcome to week 5. This week will be about basic robot vision. We will focus on two main aspects about robot vision in this week. From the perspective of object manipulation in our factory environment. Note that robot vision in general is a very big field in itself, similar to manipulation and navigation that we learned in the previous weeks. Okay. Let's set the background first. We already used some principles of robot vision implicitly in week 3 when we autonomously navigated the turtlebot. Particularly, the camera on the turtlebot was used to see its environment and obstacles and adapt its movement accordingly. However, in week 4, we saw that the robot arm near the conveyor belt moved to pre-programmed pick and place locations. Now, such a setting is all right in traditional automation settings, like in car manufacturing, where different parts come in a predefined location and also go to a predefined location. Basically, fixed or static environments with known manipulation locations. But manipulation in dynamic environments is different. There is no guarantee that an object to be manipulated will be exactly in the same location all the time. In such scenarios, we will need a camera to detect, recognize, and also estimate the pose of the object we want to manipulate. And that's the main idea of robot vision. Robot vision, also called perception, takes inspiration from the field of image processing in computer science. In real-world applications, detection, recognition, and pose estimation are performed using information from 2D or 3D camera data. However, those concepts are too detailed to include in this course. And in fact, there are other EDX MOOCs that exclusively cover the topic of robot vision, such as this one. In this course, we will use something called a logical camera that has two important features that are closely associated with robot vision, particularly in the context of developing ROS-based applications using robot vision. The first feature is that the logical camera already performs detection and recognition of known and unknown objects and also provides a pose of the objects in a certain reference frame. And this information can be integrated with our ROS application using the ROS-TF package to perform simple pick-and-place tasks in our dynamic factory environment. For example, there will always be some variability in the final goal pose that our turtle bot reaches. And hence, we cannot statically determine the place location for our object. Accordingly, let's define the goals for this week. Our first goal is to add one or more logical cameras to our factory environment. And once we do that, we will learn how to inspect and use the logical camera data. Then, our second goal is to learn the basic concepts of yet another awesome ROS package called TF, which is short for transforms. Particularly, we will learn how to specify a pose in a reference frame of our choice. Then, we will learn how to create and view an important entity of practically all ROS applications called the TF tree. And lastly, we will learn how to transform a given pose of any object from one reference frame to another reference frame as desired by our ROS application. Cool. Let's learn more about the logical camera in the next video.